This is Waacking. It's a dance movement all about freedom, self-expression, individuality, and release. And in the 1980s, this dance almost died from AIDS. This is Samara Cohen. But when she leaves the house, she's known internationally as Princess Lockeroo, the Queen of Waacking. You may have seen her trail of whack dollars, which she leaves wherever she goes. Her entire life is built around whacking. Her apartment, the locker room, has almost no furniture, so it can be a dance studio and costume closet. Her day involves practice in her apartment, classes around the city, and parties in the club spreading the gospel of whacking. And this dedication is important, because if it wasn't for people like her, the dance would be dead. So you might be wondering, what the heck is whacking?
Whacking is a style that originated in the 1970s California. It's a gay club dance, and it was created by gay black and Hispanic men. This dance style originated to disco music, and this dance was a form of expression. It was almost like a coming out of the closet. Now these men were inspired by movie stars like Greta Garbo, Marilyn Monroe, Marlene Dietrich. So these women that were so classic and glamorous and elegant was a big inspiration.
Princess Lockeroo had dreams of being on Broadway, but found her way into New York's underground dance scene, where she saw people whacking for the first time and fell in love.
It immediately changed the way that I felt about myself. The constant repetition of embodying this fierceness and this confidence, it transformed my life. It makes you feel free when you do it.
But this whole world of whacking almost didn't exist. You see, whacking emerged in gay clubs in the 1970s, and in the 1980s, the AIDS epidemic hit the gay community.
A puzzling new disease has appeared in the past couple of years that is spreading rapidly among homosexuals, and it is a disease that is fatal.
Many of the originators of the dance passed away, and with them, so did the dance. For two decades, no one whacked. Until this guy, Brian Footwork Greene, decided he wanted to bring it back in 2003. He wasn't one of the original whackers, but he knew who was. Brian sought out Tyrone Proctor, an OG whacker and Soul Train dancer who left the scene with everyone else in the 80s. With some effort, Brian got Tyrone out of retirement to bring whacking back to the world, training the next generation of whacking superstars like Princess Lockeroo. Now she's doing her part to pass the dance on.
Whacking is making the music visual. As the music goes, bum 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 bum, bum 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 bum. That's what you have to do with your body.
Whacking is not exactly these specific dance moves. Whacking is more of the way that you are expressing the music through the dance. It's not necessarily just the arm movements and the wrist movements. It's more of the feeling that goes with it.
So we just had an amazing whacking class, but whacking was not made for classes, it was made for the clubs. So where are we going next?
We are going to Whacktopia. It is the disco party of your dreams, and you're gonna get to see what whacking is really like in the clubs.
All right, let's go.
It is midnight on a Tuesday. We are in the Lower East Side now. We're about to go to a big whacking event at a dance club. About to turn up.
When Lockeroo busts into the club, everybody stops.
Live your life without a care. People standing at the bar.
Every dance is unique. Every dance has its own history. Every dance makes you feel a different way. But there's something special about whacking, about its underground origins. The near extinction of the dance in the 1980s, the re-emergence in the early 2000s, and the growth of the dance because of the tireless efforts of people like Princess Lockeroo, and the incredible power this dance has to make people feel confident and powerful in their own skin.
I'm Princess Lockeroo, the Queen of Whacking.
Rally on!
Feel the music, feel the music.